Hi and welcome. We're going to look today at the advanced features of Kalicube Pro for writing the description for your entity. And we're going to use Boowa Kwala as an example. I'd already written this description a while ago, which describes who she is, who her family is, where she lives, and even at one point that she's in a TV series. So that should be quite clear. And we're going to look at whether Google thinks it's clear or not. So that's the text I've already entered into Kalicube Pro. Female yellow koala. Mummy koala is a koala who appears in cartoons online and on TV. So I'm being fairly clear there. And then I talk about she likes activities and so on and so forth, which are the things that are important to me. Now I'm going to ask Google. We ping its NLP, its natural language processing, and we ask it, what have you understood of this text without the context of the website? Because if you look here, we're in the website and we're in the context of Boowa and Kwala and the series, and you see here the breadcrumbs make that very clear. So Google has other clues, but without those clues, what does it think? It thinks we're talking about wildlife, thinks we're talking about hobbies and leisure, and it's incredibly confident. It thinks that the relevancy of my text to wildlife and hobbies and leisure is very, very strong. Furthermore, it's actually guessed that we're talking about Boowa Kwala, who is a person, but it's guessed the entity with two mentions. And it thinks we're talking about an island. It thinks that's really important, which actually isn't within the text. And it's actually found a known entity who is Boowa Kwala with two mentions. Now, if I click on that link, we'll see that it has actually found the correct entity. So we're going to try and work on that a little bit. Now, there's a big difference between guessed, which is I don't know who the entity is, but I can guess it from the text, and the known entity, which is from the text, I can imagine who or what entity you are actually talking about, and it's an entity I already know. And that's obviously much, much, much stronger. And you will notice that here we have a small k and here we have a big k. So your grammar rules from school come into play and we immediately correct that. Look for the other ones. There you go, there's another one there. We can correct that. Ooh, moala, that won't work. Koala. And I click on evaluate again. And all of a sudden we're at 74% because I added a capital letter and it knows that Boowa Kwala is a proper noun and it's the person. Five mentions. And if you look here, I'll look using search. We have 1, 2, 3. And it's actually guessed that this is also that same entity. So you don't have to be incredibly heavy-handed. You can use she. You can refer indirectly to the entity and Google will still get it a lot of the time. Not all the time. Don't rely on it. It's still a machine and it still doesn't fully have the imagination that we do as human beings. But we still have the island, which is terribly important. Female yellow koala. It thinks we're talking about a person, which is correct. And it thinks it's incredibly important. Now, why? Because it's at the beginning of the text. That beginning of the text is phenomenally important. So what I've now done is started to say, at the beginning of my text, she's a fictional character, the subtitle. That's who she fundamentally is. She is obviously a yellow koala, but in order for Google to understand, if we say a fictional character, we're obviously getting much closer. And all of a sudden we've got people in society and we've started to get TV programs. The idea of a fictional character has suddenly taken on immense importance in Google's mind. And it's added an extra entity mention here. It's understood one extra mention of that specific entity and we're suddenly up to 82%. You don't need to aim for 82%. The advantage I have here is that Google knows who Boowa Kwala is. And despite appearances, Boowa Kwala is relatively unambiguous because there aren't other characters called Boowa Kwala. We still have the problem with the island is up there, but we've got cartoons now, which is looking great. We've got TV, Indian Ocean, Africa. I don't think that's particularly relevant. We've got Kwala, who is Boowa Kwala's daughter, who appears right down there, but the percentage of importance is only 1%. As you can see, these percentages change quite dramatically when we change relatively small elements. One thing that is interesting is that you don't need to obsess about a couple of percent here or there. You're looking for how much does Google know, known entities in this case here, how much is it guessing, how well is it guessing, what kind of entity are we talking about, and how much repetition do we get in this list, i.e. how many times have you referred to this entity and Google has thought, oh, that's two different entities they're talking about, which is obviously a bad thing. We want to bring all those entity mentions together and make sure that Google knows we're talking about that specific entity throughout the text, and get this score up to 82%. I'm astonished at how quickly that got up to 82%. But what I've actually done is created a template. I worked on this on a Sunday morning for Daddy Koala, who is a husband. And as you can see, I've divided it into the modular Kalicube system. And we're being very clear that it's a television series. There's some music involved. There's a fictional family. There's an actor involved. In this case, me. On the other case, Céline Chevrier. And there are creators. So we can actually take that whole text, put it for Mummy Koala, and we're just going to change Mummy for Daddy. This is just to save time. Obviously, this took me, it actually took me 4 hours to write this text for Daddy Koala and get it exactly right. Mummy Koala is a fictional character who appears in the Boowa Kwala television series and web series. In both the television series and web series, she is voiced by, and then we have to put the correct name because I didn't do the voice of Mummy Koala. That would have been Céline Chevrier. Now, in this case, Google doesn't necessarily recognize Céline because she isn't in the knowledge graph, but that does help enormously associating this character with somebody that Google already knows. So we have the television series in this modular system, section by section by section, with these pseudo H2s. In the television series, produced in 2000 by ITV Studios, Up to 10 and Radio Canada, three entities Google already knows, and screened on television in over 20 countries around the world, Mummy Koala, remembering to maintain the capitalization, this is a proper noun, it's an entity, in multiple episodes during the vroom vroom, let's assume she was in the vroom vroom, the 4 o'clocks is what can we do, La and the Garden Orchestra. So these are episodes of the TV series that Google already recognizes because I fed them into Google's knowledge graph over the last couple of years. Now, music, she sings, Google will recognize. We're talking about Mummy. It knows she's a female and it will associate this she with Mummy Koala and get an extra mention without me having to repeat it. Sings vocals on several tracks on the Boowa Kwala music album. I've put quotation marks around this because when I didn't, Google didn't recognize that it was one individual thing. It kept breaking it up into chunks. The quotation marks can help Google to understand that the whole thing goes together. Brackets are also quite good for that, so you should try both, including lead vocals on the song, the sing-along Ling Long Birdie song, and a guest appearance on the song, the Twirly Dance Game. These are, once again, capital letter, capital letter, capital letter, capital letter, capital letter. Songs that Google recognizes. If I search for the Twirly Dance Game in Google, we will see that it recognizes it. It's a bit confused, but it's doing a good job. It's found the right song, knows where it is, and it knows it's related to Boowa Kwala and therefore Mummy Koala. So back to writing the description. Fictional family, Mummy Koala is Koala's mother. Let's get this right. Oh, and I use the sing-along ling-along birdie song because it's totally unambiguous. Nobody else has been idiotic enough to call one of their songs that. Google thinks that it might be called the sing-along sing-along birdie song because logically that's what it should be called, but it's still got it right. So unambiguous recognized entities are really helpful for Google to understand what we're talking about, if we can link it to the entity we want to describe. Mummy Koala is Koala's mother. She, once again, She is Daddy Koala's wife. Very boring for the user, but I've described a relationship. I think it's actually useful for the user in this particular case. You obviously need to find the balance between explaining to Google and making sure that your user doesn't think that's really, really, really idiotic and silly and uninteresting. She is Daddy Koala's wife. She is Grandma Koala's daughter. And she is Grandpa Koala's daughter. Once again, relationships, very strong relationships that Google recognizes and can hook on to. Actor, the role of Mummy Koala is played by, and let's copy paste her name, Celine Chevrier. Creators of the Boowa Kwala fictional universe, very explicit. We're talking about the fictional universe of Boowa Kwala. I don't expect the machine to recognize that Boowa Kwala are a fictional universe without me being explicit about it, especially as there are multiple entities called Boowa Kwala, including a song, a web series, a TV series, and two characters, Boowa, obviously, and Kwala. It was created by Veronique Barnard and Jason Barnard. Now, I could say Veronique and Jason Barnard. Google still has trouble getting the Veronique and the Barnard to associate if I don't put it right next to her name. So we can still assume Google is a little bit slow on that kind of thing, and we can help it. Now, obviously, if it's too heavy-handed for the user, I can remove that, and it's not such a big deal. It's small matter within that. But what I've managed to do here is describe that it's a television series. I've gone away from this wildlife, leisure, focus much more on this and hopefully a little bit less on that. Now let's analyze that. And bingo, we're in TV shows and programs. It's incredibly confident. It's dropped all the others because it knows we're talking about a TV show and a program. Mummy Koala, 80%, 9 mentions. Now let's have a quick look at Mummy within that text. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it's got indirectly 5 other mentions to her, which I would assume are this one, probably that one, and that one. We can actually look in to find out which ones they are, but that doesn't really matter. We've got 9 mentions of a specific entity that Google recognizes specifically as Mummy Koala. We have television series number 2, which is better than Island. Web series, brilliant. Work of art, perfect. Koala, it's understood that, that Koala and Boowa are other kinds of entities. It isn't very sure which. It's got the television series again. Now, why it's repeated it isn't very important. Obviously, 1% plus 7%, that makes 8%. That's fine. The least repetition as possible is best, but you will never avoid some repetition. Google can't quite get it yet. Television series, 3rd time, in fact, now I notice it. Because it's got this capital letter, it's confused. I could potentially change one of the television series words. Television, 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 television. Yeah, it's being fairly idiotic, but if I change that to a small t, we would get, there you go, television series. It's got rid of, oh, it still thinks it's different because it's separated from the rest. So that just demonstrates, don't be obsessed by the details. What we want is to have the main entity recognized at least 50%. 50% means that the text is majoritarily about this specific entity. If it's a known entity, that's great. If it's a guest entity, because you're not already in the knowledge graph, that's also great. It's also much more difficult to do. And we have the sing-along, ling-along birdie song, which Google has recognized. The system at Kalicube recognizes, you can see here, the ID that Google has found for it. And you can click on those and you can see, has it got the right entity explicitly? Celine Chevrier is a person, but it doesn't recognize a specific entity in the knowledge graph because she isn't in the knowledge graph, but it has guessed that she's a person and it's found the 2 mentions that we gave of her and it associates them together. Family television, after about this, beyond 5 and 6, you don't need to worry too much about how relevant these terms are. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 need to be very relevant. If they're not, you need to rework the text. I've obviously got it pretty nailed here, but as I said, I spent 4 hours working on Daddy Koala, and I now have a template for the entire family. We can see here we've got music, vocals, daughter, countries, world, music album. It's recognized the song. There you go. It's recognized the album. There you go. And all the songs, because I've fed it to Google previously. Now, that really does insist on the fact that once you've fed Google information on related entities, it really starts to understand each entity that you wish to hook on to those entities that you have already communicated. So working on entities in groups is phenomenally important. Boowa Kwala organization, bit strange, but it still sees their musical group. I think it's considering that a musical group is an organization. They made lots of albums. That's something I'm working on, trying to get that more clear in Google's brain. Daddy Koala, it's recognized him. Grandma Koala, here we go, this is glorious. And what it's done, as you can see, is it's recognized all these entities around the primary entity that I'm describing, who is Mummy Koala. And this makes for an immensely powerful context cloud, and so on and so forth, all the other ones I actually mentioned earlier on, and it's actually recognized myself. Here we've got Veronique as a person without recognition. If I now go back here and I add Barnard, I'm hoping this will work. Reanalyze it using Google's own natural language processing to see Veronique Barnard is now recognized. She is an entity within Google's knowledge graph. I actually get the description from my own site, and she is recognized as an actor, which is wonderful, because she used to be a music artist, and I've managed to convince Google that she is an actor, which she is principally. So very small details within the text can actually help Google to better understand, and just adding Barnard here helps Google to understand. Now the question then is, does that bother your user? Yes or no? You need to find the balance between helping Google to understand, making sure that your user, your audience, are comfortable with the text you have written. So, last item on this whole list is to say that this text, I keep scrolling up and down because I'm thinking about kind of how powerful this template I wrote for this family are, and the fact that it took me 4 hours to write the first template. So don't think you're going to write the perfect text straight off the bat. And these templates, because I've worked on them so much, are relatively easy now for me to write. And once you get practiced at it, you will become just as good, I am absolutely sure, because what you will be able to see is when it recognizes entities, when it guesses entities here, how important it would appear to be, and how you can merge mentions of an entity when Google tends to duplicate them. Now, the point about this is, if it's got that level of understanding of this text with absolutely no context, just think how confident it will be in that understanding once it finds that text in the context of a site with a hierarchy of Mummy Koala, who is one of the characters of the Boowa Kwala series on the Jason Barnard site, the creator. That is going to be very powerful once you spread that description around the web. If Google has understood it out of context, every time it sees it in context, it will be increasingly confident in its understanding of that entity. Thank you very much.